We're now joined by Police Lieutenant Colonel Gerard Pelare. He's the spokesperson of the Special Investigation Task Group Degamo. Sir, good morning to you.
Good morning, Ma'am Karen.
All right. I know there's now a fourth suspect in the killing. Can you talk about that more? So have you also discovered or found the motive?
Yes, ma'am. As of now, we have four suspects arrested already in our ongoing hot pursuit operations. Actually, ma'am, right now, we are still conducting relentless and hot pursuit operations against the remaining suspects po. As to the motive po, we will request that we will be given the leeway po and hindi pa po namin pwede pong i-share yung mga substantial information because as we have mentioned, ma'am, we are still conducting hot pursuit operations.
Okay. Now, the three suspects, the three earlier suspects that you've arrested are former military personnel, tama?
Yes, that appears in their identification cards po, that they were ex-military officers but they were dishonorably discharged from the service already. As per our coordination with the Armed Forces of the Philippines.
Okay, and what about the fourth suspect? Is the fourth suspect a military man as well?
Yes, ma'am. The information that we got from the arresting officer, he is also a former member of the military who was also dishonorably discharged from the service.
Okay, and have they become gun for hire? Or have they been hired assassins?
Yes, that is what we are looking at now because basing from their backgrounds po and their origin po, yung iba po is from Mindanao. So it appears that they were just gathered for the conduct of this gruesome crime po.
Okay, now let's go back to essentially how the killing was conducted because this happened over the weekend. So we may have some viewers who are not aware of the details. This is the murder of a governor. This is Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo. But let's not forget, there were eight others with him that were murdered and killed at the same time.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. What transpired? Paano po nangyari ang pagpatay?
Yes, ma'am. The report that we got is during weekends po, the governor receives in his residence. Yun po yung mga constituents natin na nanghihingi po ng assistance. So on that Saturday po, same yung ginagawa niya, he was receiving his constituents po when at around 9:40, a group of armed men barged in his residence and they just shot and fired upon the governor and the rest of the victims po. So,
were the others, I'm curious, the other victims, yung walong ito, were they assistants of the governor? Tao sila ng provincial government?
There were security detail po na okay. Nasaktan din. There were two, as reported. May mga government barangay officials din po. There were also government employees na sawi. And, actually, there are also 13 victims who incurred major injuries po and are now being attended to in various hospitals. So,
oh, wow.
Po yung nangyari.
No, yeah, this is tragic in the sense, number one, the eight who died, they were not able to fight back. Wala naman silang baril. They were just shot at.
Yes, but the report that we got, there is a possibility po na the security detail of the governor was able to retaliate because in the subsequent recovery po ng vehicles na ginamit, there were blood stains. Kaya po pinaprocess na po ng SOCO to identify po the suspect. So what we have in mind is that probably one or few of the suspects were also injured during the incident.
Okay, and we're now showing videos. Actually, it'll come back to that. There's a contributed video of gunmen entering the gate, no? In the video. Who was shooting this video? I'm curious, is there a CCTV in the place? Or somebody was on top? May tao sa taas tapos kinunan niya?
This is the origin of this video po is the CCTV in the residence of our governor po.
Okay, and these were the armed men who came in and shot the governor? These were the men?
Yes, ma'am. Some of them are identified as those arrested persons
po. Okay, pero bakit ganun sila kakalma? O yun ang unang tanong ko, may mga may baril. Bakit makakapasok sa residence ng governor na wala man lang naghihinto sa kanila sa labas ng gate? Diba? Isipin mo, may, yung governor, it's, yun ang araw niya na tumulong sa constituents. May ilang papasok na kabaril, but wala man lang hihinto na, uy, bawal pumasok. Sino kayo? Bakit kayo may baril?
Yes, ma'am. Obviously, ma'am, this is a well-prepared operations. No? They know the events unfolding inside. Nag-casing po ito sila. And makita ninyo, ma'am, they are highly trained po na mga operatives. So they were trying to overcome the security detail of the governor.
But I don't see them overcoming any kind of detail. I
yes,
mean, they're just walking in.
Yes, ma'am. It's a Saturday po, kaya... the people are coming in and out. And as you can see po, they were disguising po as government forces. Kaya po, they were able to gain entrance.
Oo, but yun ang sinabi nila. Government forces sila.
Opo.
Oo. Because have you ever actually checked if they were in cahoots with anyone from the governor's group?
That is part po of the investigation right now, no? The arrested persons are being they are undergoing custodial debriefing po, and we believe substantial informations were taken from them which are now being utilized for our subsequent operations.
Okay, so I know you won't tell me exactly what you found, but is it fair to say that this is politically motivated?
Everything po, all angles are being looked upon, and we will respectfully decline po to give details because as we speak po, operatives are still on the ground conducting armed force operations.
Okay, but have they already admitted you have four suspects? They're undergoing tough questioning, I'm assuming. Has it come to a point that they've already admitted who hired them?
I am not at liberty to divulge that right now, ma'am, because as we speak po, may mga operatiba po tayo sa ground looking for the remaining suspects.
But you believe they were hired. Is that fair?
Yes, that's one of the possibilities po, because as I've mentioned, they are not from Negros Oriental. They were just, they are like imported here to do this specific crime po.
Okay. At least have they shared na bayaran na ba sila or... babayaran pa lang?
I don't have specific information regarding that, ma'am.
Okay. So you now have four suspects. Ilan po bang suspects ang hinahabol po ninyo?
We are looking at 10 to 12 suspects po. So we have accounted five already. So we are still conducting relentless operations to against the remaining suspects. Anyway, ma'am, the armed forces of the Philippines and the PNP have been scattered strategically all of Negros Oriental to make sure that they will not be able to get out. So nakasil na po lahat ng ports, roadblocks are established already.
Okay, but I'm curious in terms of local politics, has your team been made aware of already of his, let's say, former opponents, somebody who's had a bad relationship with in the last elections? Umabot na ba sa ganun ang investigasyon po ninyo? Or did he have other business dealings other than politics?
Opo, ma'am. Everything po, all angles are being looked upon. Intense political rivalry, personal relationships, even communist terrorist groups are being considered. Mm-mm. Right now po, our SITG, Special Investigation Task Group, is focusing, conducting thorough and comprehensive probe to determine po the suspects of this gruesome crime.
All right. On that note, I want to thank you so much for joining me today, Police Lieutenant Colonel Gerard Pelare. Mag-ingat po kayo, sir. Thank you.
Dagang salamat, ma'am.